Audiobooks.com presents The World's Most Dangerous Geek and More True Hacking Stories by David Kushner. Read for you by Nan McNamara. Introduction. Every day, it seems, we hear stories about hackers. Hackers breaking into the computers of banks, governments, and corporations. Some are criminals, coding to exploit and destroy. Others are activists, using their tools to challenge institutions and fight for freedom. But often these characters linger in the shadows. Who are they? What makes them tick? Are they our allies or our enemies? For the past 20 years, author David Kushner has been exploring these questions, interviewing key players, and providing much-needed answers. The World's Most Dangerous Geek and More True Hacking Stories is a riveting collection of his exclusive reports from the online underworld. We meet a fugitive hacktivist from the notorious collective Anonymous, a lonely Floridian who hacked the emails of the biggest celebrities in Hollywood, and two artificial intelligence researchers who were both found dead in the same mysterious way. You will come away from these stories with an appreciation for the awesome power of the internet, both to make fortunes and erase them, to build lives and destroy them. The World's Most Dangerous Geek. Justin Frankel, the man who made it easy to swap music online, has even bigger plans. The most dangerous man in music is ready to rock. It's Saturday night in San Francisco as Justin Frankel, gangly and bedheaded, ambles through the warehouse garage he aptly calls his playground. He has come here, as he often does, to screw around on his drums or his Moog or electric guitar. But first, he needs his fog machine. "It's around here somewhere," he says, checking under his makeshift concert stage, a riser set against a wall postered with naked women. Then he looks under his Porsche, his go-big scooter, his gutted Audi. He pokes his head behind a hacked Xbox, pulsing the word SE Xbox onto a 42-inch plasma screen. No luck. Not to worry, there's always his light show laser. A 25-year-old, once worth $100 million, deserves his toys. If you've downloaded a song in the past few years, it's in large part because of Justin Frankel. 7 years ago, when he was just 18, he invented Winamp, the first software program that made it easy to play digital music on your computer. A few years later, he created Nutella, the vast and vastly controversial online network that lets you swap songs. The fact that Frankel secretly did the latter while working at America Online, the company behind his multi-million dollar buyout, made him both the internet's greatest punk and hero. Now he's about to punk the industry again. That's because after years of being muzzled by AOL for igniting the pirate nation, Frankel is breaking his silence. "This is an environment where I don't get to do what I want to do," he says. What he wants to do is even more radical than Nutella. And to do this, he needs to break free. 80% of the people at AOL are clueless, he says. When I ask him if they have anything to fear by him leaving, he replies, half-jokingly, "If anything, they have more to fear when I'm working for them." Frankel kills the lights and gets behind the drums. Despite my rusty chops, he encourages me to strap on an electric guitar. "Things I've done are often interpreted as anti-record industry," he says, "but it's really about empowering people." Back in 1996, when a 17-year-old Frankel downloaded his first MP3, Pepper, by the Butthole Surfers, no one really cared about such things. Napster didn't exist. The Recording Industry Association of America hadn't sued a 12-year-old girl in the projects for downloading, among other things, the theme song to the TV show Full House. And America Online hadn't started hemorrhaging 2 million subscribers a year. The son of a lawyer and a postal worker slash health food store employee, Frankel grew up in a mobile home in the hippie nexus of Sedona, Arizona, where he spent his afternoons taking apart old radios, or constructing elaborate model airplanes. Once Justin gets an idea for something, his father Charles says, he finds a way to create it. Unchallenged by classes, Frankel took control of his own education, largely directing his own homeschooling. Around then, he also started messing with his brother's Atari 8-bit computer. By the time he started high school, he was a self-taught whiz. He ran the school's computer network and racked up a better than 4.0 GPA in his senior year. In addition to writing an email program for the school, Frankel coded software he called Happy Bug, which would log the keystrokes of people at their machines. It would show you everything they typed, he recalls. But he didn't create the program to steal tests or eavesdrop, he says. It was more like, cool, look what I can do. After graduating from high school in 1996, he enrolled at the University of Utah. But he clashed with his more traditional computer science professors and dropped out after two quarters. A few months later, he uploaded Winamp. The name is short for Windows Audio MPEG Player. With its equalizer, playlist features, and trippy visuals, Winamp trumped every MP3 player out there. In a year and a half, 15 million people downloaded the program. A sizable portion even sent in the voluntary $10 shareware fee that Frankel had requested, reluctantly, on his parents' advice. With tens of thousands of dollars coming in every month, his dad took off time from his law practice to help field calls from companies that wanted to cash in on the outfit Justin nihilistically called Nullsoft, a play on Microsoft. But Justin, despite buying himself a used turbo Audi, was in no rush to sell out. Early on, he had included the tagline, "Winamp whips the llama's ass," riffed from a line in a song by the late schizophrenic Chicago street singer Wesley Willis, on every player. When a pharmaceutical company offered big money to adapt Winamp for use in sales presentations, on the condition that he remove the tagline, Frankel balked and the deal fell apart. Soon, Frankel coded another program, Shoutcast, do-it-yourself broadcasting software that let people stream their own audio over the net. By 1999, Winamp and Shoutcast put digital music and its young creator on the map. And America Online wanted in to the tune of $100 million. Frankel responded with two words, "Holy crap!" In addition to acquiring Nullsoft in the summer of 1999, the company paid $300 million for Spinner, the leading online radio service at the time. These were the boom years, and the message was loud and clear. The future of music was on the information superhighway, and Justin Frankel, hired to further develop Winamp as the standard MP3 player, was going to drive it. And AOL was going to own it. In a statement, AOL's chief operating officer, Bob Pittman, the guy who had previously created MTV, trumpeted, "Combining these leading internet music brands with the audience reach of our brands will lift music online to the next level of popularity." He had no idea. "All right, Radiohead," says Frankel, shuffling to a row of CDs inside Amoeba Music, a sprawlingly hip record store in Haight-Ashbury. He's wearing jeans, a white T-shirt, and a black fleece jacket. He has the patchy, chia-like beard of a dude who doesn't give a shit about patchy, chia-like beards. "When Hail to the Thief leaked on the internet," Frankel says, "I was like, right on. But I still bought the CD. I think it's wrong to download music and never give anything to the artist. But if you download something and you're like, this sucks, and you never listen to it again, I don't think there's anything wrong with that." A true child of Sedona, Frankel maintains a heartfelt sense of morality and karma. It's this passion to do right by music fans that inspired him to create the very thing that so many people consider to be wrong, Nutella. Nutella's birth came at the end of what Frankel now calls his very short honeymoon with America Online. At first, it seemed like the ultimate setup: good money, a nice office, and the freedom to work on the next version of Winamp. But it didn't take long for things to sour. almost immediately after the deal.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.